Thank you for joining us on Ask the Rock Crochet today. Warm wristband. It's very versatile for any lover, any crochet lover. So gather your crochet materials and I'll show you how to make this very quick and easy wristbands. With 3.0 mm crochet hook, we're going to make the wrist band like so. Make sure that you measure around your wrist. Now we're walking through the back hump, pass your hook through to make a joint circle or slip stitching around like so. Now chain three. Your three chain stitches count as your first double crochet. Yarn over, go into the back of the next chain stitch space, pull through and make your double crochet. You have made two double crochets. Yarn over, you have two loops on your hook, go into the third space, pass your hook through, yarn over, pull through. You have three loops on your hook, yarn over, pull through two, and yarn over, pull through two. This is what you need to do all the way around. When you're nearly at the end, make your double crochet like so. We're going to be slip stitching into the top of your double crochet, just like, and you've completed your first round. You can weave in your yarn tail and work it in as you go along. It's gonna make the wristband easier for you at the end. Now you have two loops on your hook, you're gonna go around your very first post and make a front post double crochet. You can attach your yarn marker at the bottom if you find it easier, so you know where you're starting from. So pull through to make your front post double crochet. You need to go all the way making front post double crochet until you have a total of, for mine I have 12 front post double crochets. The beginning chain for my wrist band is 25 chain stitches, but yours might be different, might be a bit more or less, it depends on what you have. You can pick any spot all the way around to make your heart shape in the middle, because you're making a round object, so wherever you put your heart, that's gonna be your front. So what I've done is I've divided my stitches 12 on one side and 12 on the other side, and I'm gonna pick the middle one to start my heart. So this is how it's looking so far. Now get hold of your second color 2. I'm using a pinky on here so you can see better. Attach it and just make a front post with that color, just one front post double crochet. Pick up your color one, which is my blue, pass it through to secure it, and then make front post double crochet all the way around till you get to just before you get to your second color, the pink color. Now when you get to the beginning area, all you need to do is just slip stitch into the top like that, and then yarn over and make your front post double crochet. Carry on and happy crocheting. Now I'm attaching my pink yarn and I'll be making 3 front post double crochets, one in each 3. That's 1. Pull on your tail to secure your blue yarn into the middle and make 1 front post double crochet, and into the one after that, 1 front post double crochet. So you have 3. This will be your 3rd round. Attach your blue yarn and carry on all the way around with the blue color till you get to where we are putting our heart shape, just there. Don't forget, when you get to the beginning area, you need to slip stitch just like so and make your front post double crochet. Attach your pink yarn now. When you're attaching, you can adjust the tail at the back as you go along. Now make 1 front post double crochet, front post double crochet, front post double crochet in the middle there. Front post double crochet and 1 more. And for this round, you should have 5 pink front post double crochets to form your heart shape, just like so. Remember to pull through your blue yarn and secure. So carry on with your front post double crochets all the way around till you get to where your heart's about to start. You need to start 1 before your pink heart. And for this round, we're going to have a total of 7 pink front post double crochets. You can secure your yarn at the back by walking through like so. One more front post double crochet, and we go back to the blue yarn, or whatever color you're using. So you can see the heart is shaping up nicely. So carry on. We're going all the way around. Front post double crochet. Coming to our heart shape, and we're going to make, for this round, we're going to have a total of 9 pink front post double crochets. By doing so, it's making your heart shape wider, and then we carry on. One more. Pull through. This is how it's looking. It's looking like a upside down triangle at the moment. Attach your blue yarn and carry on with your front post double crochets all the way around. When you use the front post double crochets, it makes your wrist warmer, or wristband. It makes it thick and cozy, and you know, soft, and keeps you warmer than any other pattern. So with the blue yarn, we're still going all the way, front post double crochets, front post double crochet. If you don't know how to make a front post pattern, there are many tutorials and you can follow one here on Answer Row Crochet as well. It's pretty easy to make front post. Attach your pink yarn or your color 2 yarn, and we're going to make one front post with a pink yarn, second one into the next, into the third, we'll make front post, into the fourth, we'll make a front post. Now we're going to drop the second color, the pink color, and pick up our blue color. So this will be the middle, and we're making just one blue front post, or your color one front post. Your color one is your main color. Go back to your second color, which is my pink one, and then we're making four pink double crochets, one in each. Then we go back to the blue color, and with the blue yarn we make front post double crochets, one in each, all the way around. We're coming back to where the heart is, so we're going to start again with the pink yarn and make 1, 2, 3, 4 double crochets, pick up the blue. Now with this round, you're repeating the round you've just done, exactly the same as what you did in the last round. Attach your pink yarn and make 4 double crochets with the pink yarn, then you change to the blue yarn. This wristband, the wristband is a total of 10 rounds. See the shape. Now we're coming back to our heart shape again. We're going to make with the pink yarn 1, 2 double crochets, 3, show you close up how to make the front post. So you have 1, 2, 3. Attach your blue yarn, your main color, and with the blue yarn we're going to make 3 double crochets. Attach your pink yarn, make sure it's well secured, and then make 3 double crochets with the pink yarn. Once you finish, you attach back your main color, which is the blue color, and carry on all the way. Snip your second color because you don't need it anymore. And then for this round, which is your last round, you just need to make front post double crochets all the way around. I'm using my blue yarn, which is my main color, all the way round. This is how you're going to frame your heart shape in the middle. So carry on all the way around. we're coming to the end of the 10th round. Pass your hook through those two loops and then slip stitch to secure, and your wristband is done. Snip, and then all you need to do is to weave in your hands, turn inside out, weave in the pink into the pink area and the blue into the blue area. You can use your crochet hook, and this is how it is, if you want to use it to weave in your hands and tie it to secure it. Weave the pink into the pink area and then make a knot with the two yarn tails. And snip. Now you can also use your tapestry or your knitter's needle, whichever one you prefer, to weave in the hands. All you need to know is to weave in the color one into the color one area and color two into the color two area. Like now I'm weaving in the pink into the pink area, like so, and you tie a knot and snip at the end of it. A snip. Don't forget to weave in your last yarn tail that you had at the top and secure it very well. So thank you so much for tuning into this channel. Thank you so much for supporting, watching, liking this video and any other videos that we've done in the past. If you haven't subscribed yet and you like anything on this channel, feel free to subscribe to Hands That Rock Crochet. This will help grow this channel, and it encourages to make more videos for you. If you have any requests, comments whatsoever, feel free to leave down below. Till we see you once again on Hands That Rock Crochet, we hope you have a good crochet and a beautiful journey in life. See you, bye-bye.